Guys, welcome back to the guide video. And today we are going to show off bodyguard stuff. Now, this one was highly requested for a while. I've been busy with life and so on, but this next little mini series I'm working on is called Camp Edits, which I'm going to show you guys how to do things. So for starters, we're going to edit this guy, for example. Now, you want to make sure you have your cheat engine tagged on. And this cheat table I'm going to gladly upload after this video is done. It's going to be uploaded, but you can pretty much edit anything on here, like their elements, their name, what rating they are, how much life, Musou attack, defense they have, and what skills they use. As you see here, I have it down like Veteran S. I believe Veteran S or whatever that is their AI being like dumb or smart. I'm not too sure. And then the abilities is basically the abilities. Like, we have Find Link, Wall, and Heal. But we can change that to Find Link, Wall, and Rage. And as you see, Find Link, Wall, Rage. What level is he? How much experience? And level and experience is tied, so if you do like, oh, I want to make him level 3, he's level 3. I believe 6 is the maximum level in the game. For the bodyguards, I could be wrong. And then there's also colors, like let's say you don't like blue, you want to color him like white. Well, he could be white. He's white now. You can edit bodyguards on the fly, it's pretty handy. It's and good, so you don't have to constantly grind for bodyguards, because that's kind of the one dreading thing I didn't like about 5 on here, was the constant grinding for good bodyguards. And then we can modify health stats. It displays fine here, but you actually go past the cap, like give him 2,000 health. The thing is though, once you do that and you beat a level, it'll revert back to the max value, I believe is 400. Which is this right here, the whole bar of health is 400 points. Which is about, I think, 20 to 10k health for them. I could be wrong. And then we can also modify the element. Oh, it says light. We could go, for example, shadow. Or ice. Actually, I picked ice, I meant to pick shadow. Yeah, we pick shadow. Or you can pick none at all, just leave them blank. I'm gonna go with fire for this dude. And then you can modify his looks to do as whatever you please. So for example, we could do, let me see, set 3, set 2, and then set 2, and leave the bottom as set 3, yeah. Then go down up. Yeah, and now he loads the troop. Well, not a troop, but basically the armored look. You can add actually more to this if you want to do more crazy stuff, but I would highly recommend always save stating before doing that, because the game loves to crash when you edit the bodyguard. So just be careful. Like, see, that could happen, like it'll just not load. Don't know why it happens, but it does. So I would recommend just stick with the vanilla stuff, just to be safe. That's pretty much it with the bodyguard stuff, so let's move on to, someone asked me for, I believe it was edit officers in the camp, which is pretty easy to do too. Okay, so for example, I use my avatar as a base, but, well, my ugly looking avatar on here. I have officers here for creative warrior, the first one anyway. And you can pretty much max the stats on the fly here, but just saying like, oh, 400 health. I think you could go 2200, but the thing is, you max out the health at a certain value, it actually will underflow and make you only have 5 health in battle, so be careful how much health you give your character. Then there's the amount of points, which is this, the rank, how much KOs, etc, etc. And then I have a section down here called appearance. Created means is he created? 1 meaning yes, Zero Mini, no. Now, what name are they? The max characters they have is 10 characters. And then, what gender? Oh, he's a male. But I could say he's a female if I want. We just go this up, down. Yeah, he loaded as a girl now. And let's say I want to change it back. Up, down. And there we go. And you can also edit the height and stuff. Like, you might notice he's a bit tall looking. I actually edited his height to 32 pixels higher. But you can go much more insane values, like 66. And you'll notice that he looked like he just got wider. Let me do this with you. Yeah. You might notice he looks a little slender now. That's not normal, but... See? Stuff got moved. You can see when the armor changes that I did modify it. Yeah. Yeah, here we go. We got the best warrior of the Three Kingdoms with, like, slender arms. But you pretty much get the picture. Yeah, you can do that. You can also edit how wide is he. I did 17 pixels, but you can do like a really fat character. Oops. Okay, really fat character. So for example, you can do like 45. And you might notice he looks like chubbier now. Yeah. You can go even like bigger. Like I think it's like the maximum is 230 something or 255. Yeah, and you can make a pretty stocky guy. It's pretty hilarious. Even the hands get all weird, but it's hilarious to laugh at. I did, I think it was 18 for my character, yeah. To make it kind of match my, like, height and build. And then, each part of the Creator Warrior is, like, hair, face, whatever. It's basically each part of the Creator Warrior. Sadly, there is no way to do more for them. Like, there's no way to do, like, oh, extra hair on them because it'll just not load in battle. So I've tried this so many times and it's become unsuccessful results. And then there's voices, which I gave him Guan Ping, but you could do more. Sadly, the bodyguard voices... And the ruler and all that and the troops don't work. It's just Zhao Yun's voice. Even the playable one. You could do all the playable characters and the creator characters. So you have variety for your creator warrior voices. If you do the generic officer, you have Zhao Yun's voice. But the generic officer quotes that are used in Empires. Like if you do the hero officer, it will be the hero officer quotes. But Zhao Yun's battle voices. So, like, I can say Zuozi, and it'll be Zuozi's voice. And then here we have Moveset, which I believe I did, yeah, it's the Destiny Mode Bodyguard Moveset, which is kind of buggy. But I could do, for example, Bodyguard Spear. Yeah, he'll load that the Bodyguard is waiting there all weird, but let's do something much more insane than that. Let's see. I guess, you know, let's do the Warfan, because that's the unique one I really like. Yeah, so the Bodyguard Warfan, yeah. As you see, he's waiting like the Bodyguard. You can also change what weapon he currently uses. We'll get to that in a bit. And that's pretty much it. You can also change what color each color of the clothes is. Pretty much, I have everything down here. So we're pretty much done with this section. Next section I have right here is weapons. Let's head over to that and show you. So since I gave him the fan move, so I can show you what I'm talking about. I believe it's located under items. Wait, where are the weapons located again? Right. I think. Oh my god, I hit pretty well. The one thing to know when you do bodyguard stuff is that your stats will be like near zero, really low. Yeah, this is normal. When you get a glitch like this, it means it's for the bodyguard, but not the right weapon. So I give him Sonic Spear, but I'm actually gonna give him the Bodyguard Warfriend level 3. And then lights, yeah, and then everything on 20, okay, that sounds good. The stats are gonna be pretty, like, bad, so we'll... Where's that section at? I think player changes I had it? No, okay. I have the player stats. Yeah, so I'm gonna leave this all high to, like, about... Let's see. Yeah, all at 255, and then... We're gonna pick our bodyguard. We're gonna pick, let's pick not Sinjian. This is normal when you see T-posing. It's not anything bad. It just means the game couldn't process the change. Go back here, save. Okay, I'll do the free mode, do this again. Let's see. You may get some T-posing when you modify stuff, but this is completely normal. It's not anything bad. Does he still have the Sonic Spear? No, it's a Bodyguard Warfriend. If you see the Salt and Pepper, it's not anything bad. That's the Bodyguard Warfriend just doing its thing. There we go. And spread the teachings of heaven. And as you can see, he's using the moveset. Sadly, the heal effect does not work. This moveset does not have any air charge moves, so you're stuck like this. It can air attack, though. It has arrows, but it's glitchy. Yeah, as you see, it does the same thing like Dynasty Warriors 3. Like, it'll just be a twisted body, or it'll take forever to load. That's pretty much it. I know people were highly requesting me to re-update my edit character video, which I did, and also, basically that. Oh, this move is really good at clearing crowds, look out. Yeah, you get pretty creative with movesets in here and stuff, that's what I've been doing. That's pretty much it, guys. There's not much else I could show you in this video. Besides all that, if you have any questions, feel free to reach me out on Discord. I'm on Michael's Dynasty Warriors Discord. I do plan to update more stuff, such as having more Battlefield edits and whatnot. I don't have much done right now for that, because I haven't had time, but I will update it soon. That's pretty much it. I hope you all have a good day, and as I said, feel free to reach me on Discord.